This is Cooper. This is Caden. This is the story of Cooper and Caden.
Cooper, quiet. Quiet. Can you lay down? Stay. One of my friends, Katie, was in my animal science class, and she brought in a puppy one day. And I really wanted to know what it was all about, and she told us all that she was raising this puppy to be a service dog for Susquehanna service dogs. Ever since kindergarten, I've always said I wanted to be a vet. I'm not gonna be a vet now, but I am in animal science, so I'm gonna work with animals somehow. I've always known that was the path I was gonna take. As a student, it is difficult. Before I even got a dog, my family was wondering how I would do it. How can you be a student and train a dog? And it is difficult, but there are a lot of positives to it. One is that these dogs get a campus life. They get to interact with tons of people every day, which is great for them. The Susquehanna service dogs want these dogs out in public and want them learning and interacting with the world. For the students, it's push and pull a little bit. Sometimes the dogs are great and other times not so great. A lot of Cooper's sisters that are also on campus will go to class with their trainers. Cooper barks in class, and we're trying to train that out of him right now. So there are a lot of different struggles. Some other ones are people not knowing they aren't allowed to touch them as we're walking by. Any dog with a vest, you're supposed to ask people if you can pet their dog. You can't just go up to the dog and pet it. So we learn to respond that the dog's working, so you can't touch it. Or if we are okay with them touching it, they're only allowed to pet the dog behind the vest. And that's so that the dog keeps their attention on us. I haven't had too many struggles other than some of Cooper's bad behaviors that comes with all dogs. They all have their different behaviors and way of acting. There are a few times that it can be hard because you want to go study with a group of friends for a test, but you have to stay home with the dog because the dog needs some interaction. It is very hard though because there's only so many puppies that can come to Penn State and onto campuses. So out of 15 people that want a puppy and were accepted, only 3 or 4 puppies might actually come. We have no idea what the dogs are gonna be. We're just training them to be in public and training all of their basic commands so that once they get paired with their person that they're gonna be with for the rest of their life, they're gonna be even more easily trained to do those certain tasks for their person. They can go on to help people that have PTSD. They could be a balance dog, so if the dog's big enough, it could help somebody with their balance or someone that's missing a leg. If they need the support, it could be a support dog. They can help people that are in wheelchairs open up doors, open up cabinets. They can also be with kids that have autism or Down syndrome, and they can be a comfort dog for them when they go to school. So they might be going to school every single day. We all use clickers to train the dogs, and what a clicker is it's a little device that when you hit the button, it makes a loud click noise. The dogs respond to that click noise, they know it's something positive, and from there they can understand the reward system. So if I ask him to sit and he sits, I click it and I give him a treat. They learn tons of commands. I think it's over 25 commands in basic training before they move on to advanced training. Sits, down, stay, paw. They can do their right paw from their left paw. They learn back. So back will be for when we attach a rope to a door. They'll grab onto the rope and you can say back and they'll open the door. They're learning lap, which is a comfort thing for kids, if a kid needs pressure applied to them. Availability. So I have no idea if Cooper's gonna pass. I don't think any of us really know if our dog's gonna pass or not. There's some dogs that are perfect and seem like they're gonna pass, and then they don't for some strange reason. And then there's other dogs that are super bad and don't listen, and all of a sudden they're great in advanced training. So I hope he passes. He has his faults like all dogs, but he also is very good at his commands and very good at listening. So hopefully he passes. When he does, oh, I'm gonna be a mess. I'm gonna be so upset. I'll probably cry for a while. But I think it's gonna be a really good thing for me to see. I'll be really happy to see him interacting with his new person, and we've talked about it before, and people say it's really cool to see them start to bond with someone new, and it's almost like they forget about you, but that's a good thing. They need to focus on their new owner and helping them, and it becomes a whole new relationship for the dog, which will be really cool to watch happen.